It's AumSum time!
Protective measures against coronavirus, COVID-19. Washing hands frequently. Washing your hands with an alcohol-based sanitizer kills viruses and thus stops the spread of COVID-19. Maintaining social distancing. When someone infected with COVID-19 coughs or sneezes, they spray small liquid droplets from their nose or mouth, which may contain the virus. Social distancing is deliberately increasing the physical space between people to avoid spreading illness. Avoid touching your eyes, nose, and mouth. As our hands touch many surfaces, we may accidentally pick viruses from there. Now, if we touch our eyes, nose, or mouth, we may transfer the virus. The virus can enter our body from there and get us infected. Practice respiratory hygiene. An infected person can help protect people around him if he practices respiratory hygiene, like covering his mouth and nose with his bent elbow while coughing or sneezing. Coronavirus myths. Myth number one. Eating garlic can help avoid infection. Consuming garlic has its advantages, but as per WHO, it does not protect us from COVID-19. Myth number two. Drink water every 15 minutes. There's no evidence to suggest that this virus can be flushed out of the system by drinking a lot of water. Myth number three. Don't eat ice cream. It is being believed that not eating cold food and thus keeping the body heated will make it difficult for the virus to survive. This is not true. Myth number four. Drinkable silver. Some are suggesting drinking tiny particles of silver suspended in liquid. It is risky to do so, and it is not shown to cure COVID-19 nor boost our immunity. Myth number five. Holding breath. If a person can hold breath for more than 10 seconds, then one can avoid infection. Experts say this is simply not true. Myth number six. Use of vodka as a hand sanitizer. This is not true, because it does not contain enough alcohol to kill the virus. What is a coronavirus?
It is an alien which is haunting all of us.
Oh, AumSum. Coronaviruses are a large family of viruses. They are found in animals as well as humans. Some of them are known to infect people and cause illnesses such as Middle East Respiratory Syndrome, as in MERS, and Severe Acute Respiratory Syndrome, as in SARS. Novel coronavirus, or 2019-nCoV, is a new strain of coronavirus which was first detected in Wuhan, China in December 2019. The disease caused by novel coronavirus is named as COVID-19. Here, CO and VI are taken from the word coronavirus, while D stands for disease and 19 stands for year 2019. Some people might suffer from mild symptoms like runny nose, sore throat, cough, and fever because of the virus, while some might experience severe symptoms leading to pneumonia. For some people, this disease has also proven to be fatal. Research is still on, but the animal source of the novel coronavirus has not yet been identified. Why is it hard to cure common cold?
Cause common cold wears an invisibility cloak.
No. Firstly, there are more than 200 viruses which cause common cold. Now, developing 200 vaccines for 200 viruses is impractical. Secondly, developing a single vaccine for all 200 viruses is proving to be complex, time-consuming, and expensive, as a lot of R&D is required. Thirdly, we can't make antivirals to kill viruses, just like we make antibiotics to kill bacteria. Why? Because antibiotics attack the bacteria's protective cell walls. But as viruses don't have any cell wall, antivirals will be useless. However, there might be some good news. Now, a virus survives in human body by hijacking a protein found in human cells. Researchers have developed a compound which inhibits the virus from doing so. But as the compound targets human cells, more research is needed to test its safety. Should we work out when we have cold?
We should just chill and have milkshakes.
You wish. Yes, one may work out, but for shortened duration and with reduced intensity if symptoms are above the neck, as in common cold, stuffy nose, sneezing, or jaw pain. As these symptoms are minor, one can take appropriate cold-related medicines and then put in mild exercise with proper care. Note that light or moderate physical activity may help open up the nasal passageway, thus helping us feel better. But on the flip side, there is a chance of spreading germs or viruses to others. On the other hand, if the symptoms are below the neck, as in fever, vomiting, cough, shortness of breath, etc., then one should not exercise. Our body needs rest in this case. Hence, one should not overwork as it will make it difficult to recover and may also lead to fatigue or dizziness.